Friends, today we will learn about inheritance biology. Concept of gene, meaning of allele. First is we should know about meaning of allele. What do you mean by allele? Alternative form of a gene is known as allele. Alleles are of two types, either dominant or and recessive. Or wild type and mutant type. Mendel found only two forms of a gene for all the 7 characters which he studied in garden tea. Later on, it was observed that in some cases, a gene had more than two allelic forms. The existence of more than two alleles at a locus is referred to as multiple alleles. Presence of multiple alleles adds to the variability for a character having such alleles. Main features of alleles. Let's know about the main features of alleles. Alleles have some important characteristics. First is, alleles are alternative forms of a gene. They occupy the same locus on a particular chromosome. Alleles govern the same character of an individual. A haploid cell has single copy of an allele. Diploid, two, and polyploid means more than two for a character. An individual may have identical alleles at the corresponding locus of homologous chromosomes or two different alleles. The alleles may be dominant and recessive types, or wild and mutant type. Let's know about the main features of alleles, multiple alleles. First is, multiple alleles always belong to the same locus, and one allele is present at a locus at a time in a chromosome. Multiple alleles always control the same character of an individual. However, the expression of the character will differ depending on the allele present. There is no crossing over in the multiple allelic series. If two alleles are involved in the cross, the same two alleles are recovered in F2 or test cross progeny. This is based on classical concept of gene, according to which crossing over takes place between gene but not within a gene. In a series of multiple alleles, wild type is always dominant. Rest of the alleles in the series may exhibit dominance or intermediate phenotypic expression when two alleles are involved in a cross. The cross between two mutant alleles will always produce mutant phenotype. Such cross will overproduce wild phenotype. To put in other way, multiple alleles do not show complementation. Now come to test for allelism. First test is recombination test. Earlier, it was believed that recombination can occur between two alleles, between two genes, but not within a gene. Then, if a cross between two mutants says M1, M1 and M2, M2 produces wild type in test cross or in F2, then M1 and M2 are considered as non-allelic because production of wild type is not possible without recombination. If no wild type appears in test cross or F2, then M1 and M2 are considered as allelic forms. Now, intragenic recombination has been reported in many organisms. Hence, this concept is no more valid. Second test is complementation test or complementary test. Alleles may be arranged in two ways, cis position and trans position. When two wild types are located in one chromosome and their mutant allele in homologous chromosome, it is known as cis arrangement. Thus, in cis position, alleles are linked in coupling phase. On the other hand, when one wild and one mutant type alleles are located in each homologous chromosome, it is known as transposition or repulsion phase of alleles. Supplementation refers to appearance of wild phenotype when two mutants are crossed. Complementation test is used to determine whether two mutant alleles belong to same gene or two different genes if there is complementation. The mutants are located in different genes, otherwise they are located in the same gene. Oliver, a scientist in 1940, demonstrated that intragenic recombination occurs in Longenghi gene of Drosophila. The two mutant alleles are considered to belong to the same gene if their cis heterozygotes produce wild type and trans heterozygotes lead to mutant type. If they're both trans and cis heterozygotes lead to development of wild type, the mutant alleles are located in two different genes. Thus, cis-trans test is more reliable test of allelism. Examples of multiple alleles. Several cases of multiple alleles and pseudo-alleles are known both in animals and plants. Some well-known cases of multiple alleles include four color in rabbits, wing type in Drosophila, eye color in Drosophila, self-incompatibility alleles in plants, ABO blood group in man, etc. Now, it is believed that most of the genes have multiple alleles if in-depth investigations are made. Poor color in rabbits. Let's know about poor color in rabbits. The poor color in rabbit is a well-known example of multiple alleles. In rabbits, the poor color is of four types: agouti, chinchilla, Himalayan and albino. Agouti means this has poor color and this is also known as wild type. This color is dominant over all the remaining colors and produces agouti color in F1 and 3:1 ratio in F2 when crossed with any of the 2-3 colors in rabbits. This color is represented by C. Now, let's know about chinchilla. This is lighter than agouti. The color is dominant over Himalayan and albino and produces chinchilla in F1 and 3:1 ratio in F2 when crossed with either Himalayan or albino. This is represented by CCH. Himalayan. Let's know about Himalayan. The main body is white, while the tips of ears, feet, tail and snout are colored. This color is dominant over albino and produces 3:1 ratio in F2 when crossed with albino. This is represented by CH. Now come to, let's know about albino. This has pure white poor color and is recessive to all other types. This is represented by C. Now, let's know about wing type in Drosophila. Wild variations in wing type of Drosophila is observed. There are 5 types of wing in Drosophila, with normal leaves, nibbed nose, strap, and vestigial wings. The size of wing goes on decreasing in all types. This variation in wing size is considered due to multiple alleles of the same gene. The wild type is dominant over all other types. Crosses between other wing types exhibit intermediate expression in F1 and 1:2:1 segregation in F2. The naked wings are notched at the margin. Strap wings are very narrow and vestigial wings are miniature in size. The order of dominance and gene symbol for wing size in Drosophila are normal means VG plus, kneed means VGNI, nose means VGNO, strap means VGST, vestigial means VG. These wing sizes are observed when the individuals are in homozygous condition. In heterozygous condition, the expression is of intermediate type. Wild type is dominant over all other types. Now come to eye color in Drosophila. The wild eye color in Drosophila is red. There is wild variation for eye color in Drosophila. First, white-eyed mutant was observed and later on several other colors of eye were reported. The main eye colors include wild, white, cherry, blood, yosin, apricot, ivory and cream. The wild color is dominant over all other eye colors and exhibit 3:1 ratio in F2 generation. The cross between individuals of other eye color exhibits intermediate expression in F1 and true expression only in homozygous condition. The gene symbol and dominance order of various eye colors are wild, wild means plus, white W, cherry means WCH, blood means WH, eosin means WO, apricot WAPR, ivory means WIV, cream means WCR. The variation in eye color was initially considered to be due to multiple alleles of the same gene. However, later on, it was found to be due to pseudo-alleles, self-compatibility alleles in plants. The most common example of multiple alleles in plants is a series of self-compatibility alleles. Such alleles were reported in Nicotiana and later on they were found in several other plant species like brassica, radish, tomato, potato, etc. In this species, self-compatibility is governed by a single gene S which has multiple alleles S1, S2, S3, S4 and so on. Now, cases of digenic and trigenic self-compatibility have also been reported. In evening rimoses, primrose 37 and in red clover 41 alleles of self-incompatibility have been reported. Crosses between individuals having self-compatibility alleles will lead to three types of situations. First is fully sterile, second is partially fertile, third is fully fertile. Let's know about fully sterile. When both male and female have similar alleles with S1, S2 cross S1, S2, the cross will be incompatible and there will be no seed setting. Partially fertile. Such crosses are obtained when male and female plants differ for one allele with S1, S2 cross S1, S3. This cross will produce S1, S3 and S2, S3 progeny. In other words, half of the progeny will be fertile. Now come to fully fertile. The fully fertile crosses are obtained when male and female plants differ in respect of both alleles with S1, S2 cross S3, S4. This cross will produce four fertile genotypes with S1, S3, S1, S4, S2, S3 and S2, S4. Thus, plants which have self-incompatibility alleles are always heterozygous for this gene. Now come to ABO blood group in man. ABO blood group is a good example of multiple alleles in man. The Fe blood group in human being was first discovered by Landsteiner in 1900. Before dealing with ABO blood group, it is essential to define antigen and antibodies. Let's know about antibody. Antibody is a type of protein which is commonly referred to as immunoglobulin. It is usually found in the serum or plasma. The presence of antibody can be demonstrated by specific reaction with an antigen. Let's know about antigen. An antigen refers to a substance or agent which, when introduced into the system of a vertebrate animal like cow, goat, rabbit, man, etc., induces the production of specific antibody which binds specifically to this substance. Antigens are located in the red blood corpuscles, RBC. If a person has an antigen in his RBCs, his serum has usually natural antibodies against the other antigen. In human RBC, two types of antigens, that is A and B, are present. Depending upon the presence and absence of antigen A and B, the blood group of human is of four types: A, B, AB, and O. A person with blood group A has antigen A on the surface of RBC. Person with blood group B will have antigen B. Those with blood group AB have antigens A and B. And those with blood group O have no antigen on the surface of their RBC. Recent studies have demonstrated that antigen A and B are not proteins. They are rather special type of carbohydrates. Antigen A is galactosamine and B is galactose. Antibodies B, A, non and AB are naturally present on the serum of individuals having A, B, AB and O blood group respectively. The agglutination or coagulation of RBCs leads to clotting of blood due to interaction between antigen and antibody. The blood group B cannot be transferred to an individual having blood group A because the recipient has antibody against antigen B, which is present on the RBCs of the blood group B. Similarly, reverse transfusion of blood is also not possible. The blood group B, AB does not have antibody against antigen A and B. Hence, individuals with AB blood group can accept all types of blood, where, for example, AB and O. Such individuals are known as universal acceptor or receptor. The O blood group does not have any antigen and has antibody against antigen A and B. It cannot accept blood group other than O. Individuals with blood group O are known as universal donors because transfusion of blood group O is possible with all the four blood types. The consideration of Rh means rhesus type is important in blood transfusion. Each blood group has generally two types of Rh group, which positive and negative. The same type of Rh is compatible for blood transfusion. Opposite type leads to reaction resulting in death of the recipient. These are only few examples of multiple alleles. Now it is believed that multiple alleles are present almost over all genes, but they can be identified if in depth studies are made. Pseudoalleles. Pseudoalleles refer to closely linked and functionally related genes. A cluster of pseudoalleles is known as pseudoallele series, or a complex locus, or a complex region. Main characteristics of pseudoalleles are: pseudoalleles govern different expressions of the same character. In other words, they are functionally related. Pseudo-alleles are considered to occupy a complex locus which is divided into sublocae. Thus, they occupy different positions, but on the same complex, They exhibit low frequency of genetic recombination by crossing over. In other words, crossing over occurs between pseudo-alleles, but at a very low frequency. They exhibit cis transposition effect. In trans heterozygotes, such mutants produce mutant phenotype, but in cis heterozygotes, they produce a wild phenotype. Examples of pseudo-alleles. There are several examples of pseudo-alleles. The well-known example are Loggingi genes and star asteroid in Drosophila. Loggingi I in Drosophila. Let's know about Loggingi I in Drosophila. Green. In 1949, studied Loggingi locus in Drosophila. The mutant gene produces eye with glossy, smooth surface. Several alleles of Loggingi's gene were identified and all mapped at one locus. All heterozygotes carrying two different mutants were Loggingi in phenotype. But progeny of such heterozygotes produces wild type recombinants at a frequency much higher than expected spontaneous mutation. This indicates that IZ1 and IZ2 were pseudo-alleles. Pseudo-alleles are closely linked genes which have similar phenotypic effects but can still be recombined with each other. The recombination between pseudo-alleles is very rare. Such alleles are considered to be occupying a complex locus divided into sublocae between which recombination can be occur. Star asteroid I in Drosophila. Let's know about star asteroid I in Drosophila. Star is a dominant mutant which produces slightly smaller I than wild type in S+5. Asteroid is a recessive mutant which gives much smaller I in homozygotes. The S+ heterozygotes have still smaller eyes. Thus, the order of eye size is plus greater than S+ smaller than AST greater than S+AST. The S and AST map in the same region. From the cross between star and asteroid, star cross asteroid, 16 wild-type files were recovered in a population of 57,000. This indicates intragenic recombination between S and AST which could produce wild type. Hence, these S and AST alleles are called pseudo-alleles. The studies of pseudo-alleles provide strong evidence in favor of intragenic recombination. A pseudo-allele complex locus has several units of function. Mutation and recombination, it means that a gene can be divided into subunits. Isoalleles, an allele which is similar in its phenotypic expression to that of other independently occurring occurring alleles is known as isoallele. In other words, isoalleles are those alleles which act within the same phenotypic range of each other. Alleles are of two types, that means first is mutagenic isoalleles and normal isoalleles. Mutagenic isoalleles means such alleles act within the phenotypic range of a mutant character. Isoalleles means such alleles act within the phenotypic range of a wild character. Completed. Thank you.